Welcome back to Creator View Chronicles, the series where I'm documenting the entire journey of creating my indie app, Creator View. And in this episode, we're talking about my marketing and growth strategies and how I think this thing will actually succeed. Now, as a reminder, my goal for the next 3 to 5 years is to hit that $1 million in ARR, or annual recurring revenue. And based on what we talked about in a previous video, I'm just refreshing you, that's about 5,000 customers paying me $20 a month. Again, rough numbers there will get us to that $1 million number. And again, 5,000 in the age of the internet and YouTube and global audience, not that big. So I think it's possible, but again, in this video, I'm gonna talk about the likely scenario. I'm not saying it's a likely scenario that it'll happen, but if it does happen, here's how I think it's gonna play out. And it really goes like this chart, and let's be honest, this is the typical up and to the right startup pitch deck chart. Like, this is nothing unique. I guess the only difference is I'm not trying to convince an investor to invest in me based on what I project my growth to be, but I do think this is how it's going to play out. And to put this chart real simply, it's grind it out for like 2 to 3 years, you know, building the product, making it solid. You know, it'll have the Mac app and the iPhone companion app with CloudKit syncing, working seamlessly, right? Get the product to a great spot in those first 2 to 3 years. And then you see this inflection point where it like really starts to take off. And the inflection point is what I want to talk about because that's where a little bit of the strategy comes in. Now, I think the key driver of that inflection point is going to be the YouTube guru space. Let me back up and tell you what that is because I assume most of you have no idea what I'm talking about. There's an entire genre of YouTube channels that teach people how to YouTube. Ironic, right? And they're not small channels either, right? They're 200,000, 300,000, 500,000, pushing 1 million subscribers. And I know when I was building my YouTube channel in the beginning, I don't really watch them much anymore because I've been doing this for over 4 years now. Like, I know my lane, I know what I'm doing. But for the first 2 years I was doing this, I watched their channels religiously and I know they have a huge audience. So naturally, their audience is the perfect audience for Creator View. So I definitely want to find 1, 2, 3, who knows, however many I'll end up working with. Ideally, there's just one that is a strategic long-term partner, right? This is my ideal scenario. I don't know if this will actually play out, but this is like my dreams, right? There's a long-term strategic partner. They constantly like integrate Creator View into their content organically, and they got a piece of equity in the business, so our incentives are aligned, that kind of stuff. Of course, I could always fall back to just, you know, paying for sponsorships and features on their channel. Like, that's kind of like the easy route. Like, that's the common route. But again, I would love that long-term partnership if possible. And the key to making all this happen is how I go about contacting them. It would be kind of funny if they discovered this series and started watching it. That'd be funny. That'll probably happen. But what I'm thinking is, like, of course, I could just reach out as an app they've never heard of, offer to sponsor a video. And as a YouTuber, I'm on the receiving end of all kinds of products. And if I've never heard of them, I have no relationship with them, and they're not really in the direct iOS developer business, like, I just kind of ignore them. So, and I just know that feeling of being like cold called. So I don't want to do that, although like I will if I have to. Think about a different scenario, right? That's scenario one, where we're starting off the relationship, just a cold email, they have no idea who I am. Okay, scenario one. Scenario two, again, those 2 to 3 years, I build a great product, it's awesome. And then their audience starts mentioning it to them like organically, like, hey, so-and-so, have you heard of Creator View? You should check out this app. And of course, the first time they hear it, it's like, yeah, 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 whatever. But if they hear it 7, 8, 9, 10, 20, 30 times, like, they're gonna check it out. But here's the key. When they check it out, it's gotta be a great product. Like, it's gotta be solid. They gotta use it. They gotta be impressed. Like, holy shit, this is awesome. And then the idea here, and again, this is like wishful thinking, is that they will then reach out to me. Now, think of the difference in dynamic of that relationship. Scenario one was a cold email. They don't know. I know how that feels being on the other side. I don't wanna do that. Scenario two, they love my product and they reach out to me. Now we're starting off on a great foot versus scenario one. So that's what I hope happens. Of course, like I said, that is just kind of hope. You know, if you build it, they will come kind of thing. But I do think that's a good possibility of happening. Again, the main variable, if I build a great product that people do want to talk about, that people do want to mention to them, like, hey, you should check this out. And like I said, how I actually work with them, whether that's various sponsored videos or there is that long-term strategic partnership where, you know, they integrate Creator View into their content, like, who knows how it will actually play out. But I do think it's likely, if the product is good, that's a big if the product is good, I think it's likely that there'll be some relationship worked out, and then that would be the catalyst for this curve upward, because they have huge audience that are basically exactly who I'm targeting. And I know you may be thinking, like, I'm putting all my eggs in this YouTube guru basket, and that may be the case. That is like my base strategy. I could always fall back onto the, you know, YouTube ads, Twitter ads, you know, all the social media ads. There's other like traditional marketing stuff I could do, but I do think the best possible outcome is going to be as a result of a YouTube guru partnership. So that's the main goal, and I'll fall back if I need to. But that's a big reason on why I'm creating this series, because I like to talk about this stuff. I have ideas on how I think things could potentially play out. And of course, things never go to plan, but I think it would be fun, you know, 3, 4, 5 years from now to look back and either be like, wow, Sean, you were way off. You just failed completely. Or, holy shit, you nailed that. I hope it's that one. But again, things never go to plan. You never know. But that's the fun part of creating this series. And to sum that up, right, grind it out for like the first 2 to 3 years. Really make the product great. Even though during that time period, might not be making that much money. But again, that accelerant, that inflection point where the product's great, partner up with a YouTube guru, and then the chart hopefully will start curving up like you see here. And then who knows where it goes from there, right? Virality could kick in. This isn't an app that can go viral. I guess word of mouth was probably the better word, not virality, which I guess that kind of is virality. Anyway, that's it for this episode. We'll see you in the next one.